Yeah. It's the third day of the moon. It's the third day of the moon. And I finally get to see it. Last night it was just too cloudy. Couldn't see nothing. But that would have been the best night. Yes, it would have been. It would have been a much dimmer crescent, and you could have seen the dark part better. Because you know the dark part is lit up by light reflected off the earth. The new moon was almost exactly California time, 7:30 in the evening, just about now, 3 days ago. So, 2 days ago, it was clear enough to look for it, but it was too close to the sun. 24 hours, it's not around here. You can't see it that soon. There's too many lights from the city. I believe the record is 18 hours. But 24 hours. I've never seen it 24 hours. I've seen it 30 some hours after or before. Last night would have been really good. It was 48 hours. Would have been easy to see, except the clouds were all everywhere last night. But here I am, vlogging again at night. This time I'm not under sunset, I'm after sunset. It's the end of navigational twilight becoming astronomical twilight. It's so dark. There's the star over there. Clouds are right in front of Orion. So I can't show you them. But I did show you the moon. 3 days old, the moon is. It was... oh my God, let's see now. Yeah, this is the... oh, Jesus, I get this all mixed up. The 28th day of the old moon was Friday, and the 29th day was Saturday, and the 30th day was Sunday. And at Sunday, here, the 11th, jeez, this might even be the fourth day, but however it goes, I'm so confused. Because, you know, on the one hand, locally, the moon is here at our local time, but in my calendar, I measure by universal time, which is from London, Greenwich Meridian, the zero meridian. And that's right. It was already Monday after midnight when the new moon came to London. But it was still Sunday evening here in California. So, damn. It confuses me. I like to figure it out, and then it confuses me just the same. My brother and I made a big decision. We have the house. He and I own the house that we grew up in when we were children. My mother kept it, and she got some rent from it through all the years. And she spent money to keep it fixed and repairs. And we've been fixing it and repairing it and collecting the rent on it for 3 years since our mother graduated from this mortal life. And I was telling him a couple weeks ago, good grief, it was when I went to get my first vaccination, so that was four weeks ago. I was telling him that if push comes to shove and things get really tight, we can sell the house and each have half of the price of it. Well, he, after talking with his wife about it for quite a while, they decided they want to sell it, and I'd already told them I was willing to sell it, and I thought that was one way we could get some money. So we're going to sell the house that we grew up in, down in the suburbs of San Diego. And we'll each get a few $100,000. So I'll be able to buy my mobile home and not have to worry about where I'm going to come up with the $40,000 or $50,000. Because I'll have it. But it won't be sold, of course. We just started now. It's April. Probably won't be sold until June or July. So by August, I might have some money to buy myself a little place to settle down in for the last 10 or 20 years of my life. I still want to go traveling, though. Yes, I do. I want to drive back east, especially now that my son's wife is pregnant and I'm going to be a granddaddy. Yes, I am. I'm going to be a grandfather. Woohoo! So I'm hoping to go back east this summer because a baby will be born right around the time of my birthday in October. Probably go back there. So I don't think I'll be buying any place until then, till after then. I'll probably spend some time with them and change a few diapers. You know, they're in Brooklyn, in New York City. So I'll be staying there. And I hope to see some of you on the way in Ohio and in Pennsylvania, in Washington, D.C., and in Massachusetts.